The Philippine military has asked the National Bureau of Investigation to probe the killing of four soldiers in a clash with police in the southern province of Sulu. The incident erupted after the soldiers allegedly pointed their guns at the policemen. Let's get an update on the investigation from PNP spokesperson Bernard Banac. Brigadier General, good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, Rain, good afternoon, and thanks for having me, and to our viewers, good afternoon.
May we know, sir, what is the latest on the probe? Have we finalized how many policemen were involved in the encounter, and who was it who shot first?
Yes, Rain, we have agreed with the Armed Forces of the Philippines that a third party, an independent body, would be the one to conduct the investigation for an impartial probe on the incident, and we'd like to express our deep sorrow and heartfelt condolences to the families of the slain soldiers after the incident. And it is really unfortunate, and we really didn't want this to happen, but a misencounter happened, apparently for lack of communication or lack of identification, and we didn't realize our troops, our police frontliners, didn't know that those on board the vehicle were actually our colleagues, members of the security forces. And we have a very good relationship with the AFP so far as fighting the threat against terrorism. And in that part of Sulu, as you know, the situation is really tense, Rain. Mm-hmm.
But did we finalize, sir, how many people, how many policemen were involved, and, you know, who was it who shot first?
Well, so far as the those involved, we have accounted for six members of the Hulo Municipal Police Station, and all of them are now under restrictive custody, and they have been disarmed to face the NBI probe. And it's very important that we hold our judgment and allow an independent body to conduct this probe so that we'd be able to carry out the truth and serve justice, especially to the victims. There is a police report that we're not saying that this is the whole truth. And we'd like to know also what really transpired. Was there really actual threat against the lives of police officers that triggered them to fire their guns? And all this. And we are one with our colleagues in the Armed Forces of the Philippines to really get to know the bottom of this and get to know the truth, and justice, so that justice will be served. Mm.
So how many witnesses have submitted their testimonies so far? And does it say whether the military men actually had guns with them, prompting the policemen to shoot at them?
Well, at this point, we cannot go into more details. We leave it now up to the investigating body, the NBI, to determine all of this. But we assure the public that the PNP would fully cooperate in the probe, and all these cops involved in the incident would face the investigation. And from there on, then we'll determine our next steps.
Is there a fear of a possible retaliation by soldiers for what happened, Brigadier General?
Well, at this point, we have a very good and long-standing relationship and cooperation with the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and we don't really fear that there will be another incident that would that would happen. So we just consider this as a big lesson for us, so that this would not happen again, and we'll ensure that there will be more coordination, more communication between and among our our fellow security forces members so that this would not happen again, Mary.
According to the military, General Banac, there is an initial impression that it was overkill, and there was a lapse in judgment by the policemen. Would you say the same thing?
Well, that could be a possibility, but since these were not indicated in the initial police report, we will leave it now to the investigating body, the NBI, to determine all these possibilities and really come out with the truth.
And so in terms of the investigation, what are the timings that we should be watching out for?
Well, it is very important that the investigation, the probe of the NBI would be concluded as soon as possible so that we get to know the truth and justice would be served to everyone. And if ever, if there would be liabilities, then let justice be served.
All right. On that note, Philippine National Police spokesperson, Brigadier General Bernard Banac, we appreciate you talking with us. Thank you.
Thank you.